Native people, Native culture, Native knowledge. Hi, I'm Jeannie Green, bringing you award-winning Heartbeat Alaska.
Bringing you national and international Native news, this is award-winning Heartbeat Alaska, the premier Native voice in Native programming.
There's a heartbeat, loud as thunder, revolution is in the air. There's a heartbeat deep inside our mother. Are you too cool?
Now, with Heartbeat Alaska, here's Jeannie Green.
Hello, everyone, and welcome to Heartbeat Alaska, Native news and Native information. I'm Jeannie Green. Thank you all so very much for joining us. Isn't it beautiful outside? It's been a long winter here in Anchorage, Alaska. Last week, we aired the third annual We the People Standing Our Ground March. This week, we traveled to Southeast Alaska, to Juneau, Alaska, for their We the People Standing Our Ground March 2000. It's a great show. I'll be back right after this.
For Alaska.
Hey everyone, help us welcome one of our new sponsors, Wave Wholesale Company, your one-stop supply source for village retail stores, food service customers, and government agencies. Welcome aboard, Wave.
Support for this program provided by Blue Cross Blue Shield of Alaska. We've been here since before Alaska was a state, and we'll be here when you need us. We're here. We're with you. Blue Cross Blue Shield of Alaska.
Executive Suite Hotel is the official hotel of Heartbeat Alaska. When you stay here, you enjoy the suite life. And when you register, receive a free Heartbeat Alaska baseball hat. One per registration, please. Later on in the program, we meet Jessie and Mandy on a new segment called This Generation. Last week, we aired the third annual We the People Standing Our Ground March. This week, we traveled to Southeast Alaska, to Juneau, Alaska, for their We the People Standing Our Ground March 2000.
People thought we would disappear when the federal government came in and took over. Well, we didn't. We're still here. And we're still here because we want protection in Alaska law for the subsistence way of life. Right now, we have to rely on the federal government and the federal law to protect that subsistence way of life. As Alaskans, it's a disappointment to us that we do not have those laws in our own constitution, in our own laws of the state of Alaska. We have to continue to work toward that. And I want to thank everyone who's here today because we haven't given up. None of us have given up. We're here today because we want the people of the state of Alaska to know that subsistence is still our concern. And we're still really worried about having some kind of protection in the law so that we can continue that subsistence way of life. With that, I'd like to introduce Senator Georgianna Lincoln to say a few words. We really appreciate her being here tonight, along with the other members of the caucus of the two houses. Senator Lincoln.
I want to thank the ANB and ANS for the march today. As Albert said, this is our third annual march. And the march, I think, is going to go on for years and years, and every year we're going to be here. We're going to be marching until we resolve subsistence, until we resolve some of the other issues that are so critical to us. But let me just quickly go through when the guiding principles that this third annual march is about is to live the native way of life, a subsistence way of life. And I saw a sign here. Where is your sign? A sign here that said, subsistence is our lifestyle. And then X'd off is style. Subsistence is our life. It's our life. And that will forever be that way. 11 years we have worked for a subsistence resolve. 11 years and we're still here on the Capitol steps. And you can see who our friends are. You can see who's out here today supporting the march, supporting for our subsistence resolve. And I hope you remember each and every face that is here today and those friends that could not be here, but those that chose not to be here because they are not supporting our subsistence way of life. We're talking about a subsistence life of fish, a subsistence life of game, a subsistence life of plants, a subsistence life for our children. We also must not forget that in the guiding principles of our march, it's govern ourselves, that we're talking about our tribal courts, that we have to continue that to determine our own destiny, maintain our cultural existence, our language. Our language is so critical, and we need to continue that. To transmit the blessings of our way of life to our future generations, the young children, Eddie here, who skateboarded over from Douglas to join this march. And I'm so proud of him for doing that, 11 years old, to know that this was important, and that's why we're here today. And how do we accomplish this? We need to raise the consciousness of the people throughout Alaska that this, we will not go away, that this is a march that's going to happen every single day of our lives, not just once a year, but every single day, that we're going to be talking about it on the floor. We're going to be talking about it in the meetings. We're going to have the Chamber of Commerce talk about it. We're going to talk about it at the AFN meetings. It goes on and on. And my dear friends, I appreciate so much that young, our elders, all come out to say that we are not going away, that subsistence is so critical to us. It is our life. Anabasi.
Subsistence to the native people is not a political issue. It is not a special interest issue. It is not a racial issue. It's not even a rural preference issue. To the natives, it is a cultural issue. This is what it's all about. It is a question of survival. Our subsistence way of life is rooted in spiritual and cultural traditions that have sustained us for centuries. Subsistence statewide accounts for less than 4% of all natural resources. In Southeast, it is less than 1%. Why then did a handful of legislatures hand over state management of subsistence to the federal government? Although natives are better off under federal subsistence management, we feel that the state should manage its own fish and wildlife resources, but not at the expense of our culture. Our native veterans have sacrificed in different wars to protect our way of life. We are stakeholders. And as long as we are stakeholders, we will live our cultural lifestyle as the Great Spirit intended and not the way the dominant society would have us live. Yes. With the elections coming up this fall, please remind voters of the legislatures who handed state subsistence management over to the federal government. Algonquin, be of great courage.
I think our message here today, we the people, the message should go directly to the Secretary of Interior. We're not here to talk to the state of Alaska because the state of Alaska is not listening. However, the Secretary of Interior can affect how the state of Alaska thinks and the Federal Subsistence Board. The Secretary of Interior holds trust responsibility in protecting our cultural existence and our cultural activities under ANILCA. This is not happening. We need the Secretary of Interior to come to Alaska and meet us head on and get to know what we're all about. Let us know what trust responsibility means, because we do not know. Mr. Secretary, if this is ever going to get to you, please come and visit with us. Talk to us. Tell us what trust responsibility means, because it isn't only the state of Alaska that has not kept its promise. It's also been the Secretary of Interior. We've had broken promises from all directions, and this has got to stop so we can come to a solution. It's got to start from the top, the people listening to the people, so that we could live under laws that are effective and that also protect the resources as much as we're trying to protect the resources. Southeast Alaska people support the Katie John case, where the governor of Alaska stood with the legislature against the people, the indigenous people of Alaska, to again fight our cultural existence and our rights to our streams and our fish and our precious resources. The message has got to be, this is to the Secretary of Interior, to relate to the Federal Subsistence Board, the five federal agencies that really don't know much about trust responsibility any more than the state of Alaska does. We all need this education. I'm glad everybody's here.
You know, I think this is, we're talking about subsistence, we're talking about our life way. And while we have a problem with some issues that haven't been addressed, I think what this is really about is about celebration of who we are. It's a celebration about the things that make us different. And this celebration should occur every single day. The issues of subsistence should be in all of our activities every day. Every day that we're with the land, so that we pass that knowledge onto our children, so that if they're confronted with this issue, that they have that firm ground, that firm root to draw from. And as the governor said, we can't only be healthy in our subsistence way of life. We need to be healthy in our family way of life. And we have to do this every day of every year. And when we come together like this in marches and celebrations, that we can bring that and those success stories with us, so that every year we make progress, where less and less of our children are being neglected, where less of them are being abused, where more of our children are getting the kind of quality education that they need, so that we can commingle today's education with the subsistence lifestyle that we so dearly love and want to hang on to. And it can't be just a one-day thing. We have to make that commitment, each and every one of us, to ourselves, to our families. And we can use a day like today to celebrate those things that make us different. Not so that we walk behind any person, not so that we walk in front of them, but we can walk beside them as equals, so that our children will walk beside them as equals, understanding those things that make us who we are. Thank you.
Ho ho, ye achtun de tani ach, ye yeti yai gii. Chwe yag huan yag hat has wu adi ach, huan toko kwan ki yad has wu gudi ach, nagati yai gii. Chis khat kwan a yag hat, takwan dach. Gunas chis ye wakuk wage ach singit yu khatangi. What I said was thank you very, very much, honorable people of the land. I appreciate the way that you're here today and how you're paying attention to those things that are very valuable to us. I said, may it be as if the ancestors of the Tlingit nations and the clans were all standing here before you today speaking to you as I speak to you this day. And I said, thank you very much again. And I said that I was from the community of Tlaquan, a Chilcat from the community of Tlaquan. The word Chilcat came from the place where we stored our salmon in the caches in the community of Tlaquan. The name Tlaquan means the land that will be always ours forever for the community of that in that place. Chilcat also is a Tlingit name. Yakdat is a Tlingit name. Shiatika is a Tlingit name. Angoon is a Tlingit name. Cake is a Tlingit name. Paniki, I don't know very many of you if you know that. That is a Tlingit name as well. And the list could go on. Kitchan, Khunna, all the different communities are Tlingit names. And the reason the people settled in these areas are the reasons for the salmon, for all the deer, for the mountain goat, for the moose, and all the different foods that were there in that area. And one of the things that a more modern translation for the community of Angoon, for me, the way I look at it, is a land more precious than gold. That is a modern translation that I've placed on it, because when I look at the community of Angoon, there isn't anything that you can't get from that area except maybe a McDonald's hamburger. But the point of the matter is that the food that we ate was what provided us with life. I heard people talk about education and health and welfare, and that's very important. But you know where the real key comes from? It isn't from how intelligent you are. It isn't from how smart you are. It isn't from how good you can be. The best homes are homes where mothers and fathers are together eating dinner with their children, sitting across from one another. It doesn't make any difference what color skin you are. If you sit down with your children, and even if you're eating a hamburger with your child, you are doing good health kind of things. The records indicate that. And so what we are talking about as Tlingit people is exactly that. We're talking about it as Native people as well. So I appreciate the time that you've given me to be able to just say just a few little things here. The thing that I want to say is the food that we eat are king's food. You can't beat deer. You can't beat smoked salmon. You can't beat smoked seal meat. You can't beat the smoked clams. I see them coming in little flat cans now from down 48. But you can't beat them. You can't beat smoked hooligans or herring eggs or seaweed or gum boots or stink eggs or kahakasif or ink or any of those foods. Atlein gunakish.
I've been active all my life, ever since I could remember. It was part of the survival.
To be a successful hunter and fisherman, it's important to stay fit.
I play basketball every once in a while and do a lot of walking. You feel better, you know, you feel like you can live forever.
Another Alaska Native making healthy choices.
Segment on Heartbeat Alaska called This Generation. This segment is dedicated to our youth. And today we're proud to introduce Mandy and Jessie Estes, two talented young Inupiaq girls who have moved across America to the state of Maine, a state where residents are now discovering the Alaska treasure in their midst. two Native girls dedicated to pursuing excellence through song, a pursuit that began at a very young age.
Yeah, we started singing when we were about 8, listening to country music, just singing whatever was on the radio. And when we moved to Maine, we won our school talent show. And
we started singing for our church.
Mm-hmm. That was a lot of fun.
And we're about to enter into a competition.
It's a fine arts competition at our church.
And if you are viewed as either good, really good, or superior, and if you get superior, you get to go to Orlando, Florida, and compete in the nationals.
Yeah,
and
that's our goal.
And if you win that, then you get to make a CD of Christian.
Mandy and Jessie Estes have high aspirations and high ideals. Their lifestyle is and always has been alcohol and drug free. And though Maine is a beautiful state, they still love Alaska the best.
We like Maine. It's kind of like Alaska in a lot of ways. The weather is pretty much the
same. We live on a pretty lake.
Yes, we miss Alaska.
We're going to move back someday.
Won't you for this music video?
We're all the same.
thank you everyone for joining us for Heartbeat Alaska. Native news, Native information. I love hearing from every single one of you, and I want to thank you for tuning in. You're the most important part of Heartbeat Alaska, and we really appreciate our viewers. God bless every single one of you. Thank you once again for joining us, and we'll see you right here next week.
We want everyone to know that we're standing our ground. We want our lifestyle forever. And I think that we have demonstrated in the past 2,000 years that we're going to be here for another 2,000 years.